get to work alone because Cam worked until 4 a.m.
This week on Auto Resto Mod, Jeff goes it alone to show how to install sail panels and other cool headliner-related parts on a 1967 to 69 Camaro or Firebird.
National Parts Depot is proud to offer this exclusive reproduction of the 1970 to 78 Camaro dash pad. Get one for your car and improve your ride. Check out National Parts Depot for Mustang and Cougar, Camaro and Firebird, Chevelle and GTO, Ford truck and Bronco, Chevy truck, Mopar and Thunderbird. At our four locations, we stock the largest selection of classic car parts anywhere. Visit us at nationalpartsdepot.com or call us at 888-893-FAST.
Well, I'm almost done. Pull the cover off, put the sail panels in, get the A-pillars in, get the visors in, might put the mirror in, and get to work alone because Cam worked until 4 a.m. and the boy's asleep. So, no nasty comments about GMs. Should be able to work a little quicker. In theory. Pull the cover! Let's go! Everything's gotta fight every time. Okay, so parts. Well, we've got a lot here on the table that we're gonna be doing. It looks like we're gonna be going into a whole big old deal, but a lot of this stuff is gonna be kind of set aside for a little while. Now, what I've got right here in the center are the brand new visors that we got from National Parts Depot. We went ahead and bought visors from them because, quite frankly, trying to find somebody that can do the visors, like we talked about last week, almost impossible. You can get some really nice ones to replace yours because the ones that we have, well, they're just a little suspect. The tips are all bad. The anchor point for it is all pitted up. You can't see it real good for the dirt, but I'm going to tell you right now, there's a lot of pitting going on here. There's a lot of schmutz and junk that you're just going to have to clean off. These aren't that expensive. They'll make that look so much better than trying to go in and fix these up. And speaking of fixing things up, usually on your classic car, mirrors on the inside are one of the last things guys seem to do. I don't know why that is, but I don't necessarily agree with that. The mirror on your cars typically will be foggy around the outside edges. It may even be foggy toward the middle, depending on the mirror itself. You want to go in and replace it. While you're there, you might as well do the mirror bracket as well, because your mirror bracket basically is seen through the windshield. Even if you've got a banded windshield, you're going to be able to see that, and you'll be able to see any pitting that's on here. A nice, clean, sharp-looking piece like this is going to go a long way toward making that look really good. This is one of those pieces here that we're going to have to go in and do something with down the road. We're not going to actually do anything with this today because it's a little too cool for us to paint, and that's one of the other things I'm going to go over in just a second. Too cool to paint, we're going to have to go in and do something with that down the road when we go in and paint the rest of our stuff. Next thing I'm talking about is what we're really here for today, and that's installing these sail panels on our 67 Firebird. The sail panels can really kind of be a pain in the butt for guys doing these cars, and we've gone out and looked at a couple of different ideas on how to put these in and make them work really nicely, stay in position, and look good without having to do the clips, because quite frankly, the clips really suck. So, the last thing I'm going to talk about is the remainder of what we have here on the table, and that is our interior trim pieces. Now, these two sets right here come as a set from National Parts Depot. We've already gone in and painted this just so you can see how nicely this matches to the visors that we have here on the table. I'm really happy with the color that we got from Finish Masters. Really good stuff. So this stuff, along with the side trim, which is an extra different piece, this pinch weld goes across the side curtains in the headliner. We're not going to put any of this stuff in because I want to paint it while it's just finished painted. After it's dried, I want to get it in the car. I don't want to try to install this stuff now because I don't want to take any risk of this stuff getting damaged while we're putting glass in, doing all that kind of thing. So that's what we got. And finally, our A-pillar trim, same thing. I don't want to go in and paint this yet. I want to wait until we get everything ready to go and installed. We got the glass in there and we're done with all that, but we're going to show you today how to get this where it's real easy to set up and install into the car. So, since Cam's not around today, I'm going to get busy. Okay, now I'm in the car. I've gone in and done glue work on the front section here and the back section, and I've also pre-glued my sail panel on both sides so it's got good tack, because what I want to try to do is to set this in and roll my corners and then put some pinch weld up to hold it in position. I'm also going to go in here in a moment and show you something about how to put it in and not use the pinholes. You have a pinhole right here that's supposed to be cleated in, and then you also have two more locations, one up here and one right here. And these are more adjustable. In other words, you're supposed to put the sail panel in, clip it into this position, and put it in down here. Quite possibly the biggest pain in the butt on these headliners is putting that sail panel in and using those clips. So what I'm going to recommend you do is to go in and get Velcro, like this industrial Velcro, and stick it in with the Velcro. And that should hold it in position nice and tight. And I'm going to take these, I'm going to put a piece of Velcro over the original mount position here, here, and down here. And I'm going to show you how to set that up in just a second to make it a little easier to get it to put where you want it. All right, now the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to cut this down and take some of my slevage off so that I can see where I'm at. I don't want to cut it too deep toward the staples because I want to be able to yank on this down the road if I need to do any kind of adjustments to the headliner. I've also gone in and done a little bit of glue work right here on this corner to get this to lay down a set a little bit better. You can't really see it, but there's a place in the assembly on this where you've got a cleat over. Like there must be a piece of metal here that drops, so I've got a little bit of a dip in my headliner right here. As I've said before with this kind of stuff, not that unusual. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and make sure that these places are nice and clean, because right now in South Carolina, we're in pollen hell. It's everywhere. It's in my hair. It's on the trim panels inside here. We keep this car covered and there's still pollen inside of it. So we're going to make sure that all this stuff is nice and clean. And then I'm going to go in and start putting in the soft side of my Velcro on here. And then we'll mount it to the sail panel and throw this up in position. So away we go. Okay, now I'm going to put these in. I've already got one installed. I'm making them a little bigger than they probably need to be, just so that they are covering the entire area. I'm putting the soft side toward the body. This is industrial strength. We'll see how well it holds up over time. I'm sure somebody will write in and tell me that I should use other glue. And I'll tell you this, I think that that's probably not a bad idea sometimes, but I have had instances where the glues don't interact with each other very well, and it can cause some problems. Here's my last one going over the last hole there. And then what we're going to do next is I'm going to go in and show you how to make it so that you can do this without jacking up your position with the Velcro. Because a Velcro, you want to stick it one time. You don't want to have to keep doing this over and over and over again. So I'm going to go ahead and get busting on that. All right, my weather strip adhesive is a little tacky, ready to go in. I'm going to take my sail panel and I'm going to set it up. Now what you'll see what I've got done here is, so the soft side is on the car, the hook side is on the sail panel. I put it right over the middle of where the hole is so that we got at least a relatively good position for it. I'm hoping this thing will set in pretty nice now. What I've also done is I've gone in and put some of the slevage over the soft side so that I can move this around and position it without having to pick it up off of the Velcro every time I want to put it in a different spot, because I am going to want to muck this around a little bit to make sure I get right position. So I'm going to go ahead and start laying this in. Yes, I need to move it forward a little bit. That's where it would have been a problem, is trying to get that to lay correctly. Now I'm going to take and put some of my pinch weld here. Hold it in position in the front. Biggest problem a lot of times on these Camaros and the Firebirds is that spot right there. That looks like it's going to lay in pretty nice. I like my position okay. Put down just a little bit in the back. Now you'll see down here, you can see a little bit of the paint. That's one of the reasons that I think General Motors did what they did whenever they were putting this together. That paint line right there, you can sometimes see it whenever you put this stuff up and in position. This is strictly going to be to hold this in place until I can get everything set the way I want it to be set for final. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this, pull these out. Yeah, I know the tape stayed in there. Because it's laying out away from the body a little bit. The bottom one's holding. Top ones are not. All right, now I've had to pull this down one or two times trying to do this a little bit differently than where the original mounts were because I don't like the way it's laying. What I've done now is I've gone in and I've actually put two pieces of Velcro right up near the top of the headliner. So hopefully I can get this to lay in a little bit better. I'm going to lay that there, and that even if it pulls the headliner down just a little bit, it should be fine. And I'm going to go in and reset this for better position. So I like the way that lays a little bit better now, and then I'm going to now pull in my pinch weld and finish this thing up on this side. Then we're going to move on to finding your mount positions for your other stuff, which now, because of the way we set the headliner up last week, should be a lot easier. All right, on to the next thing. All right, now what I've done is since we put our screws in here last week when we did the headliner, we now have the spot for all of these. You can find them easier. And what you do is you take a pair of scissors and you cut across it. I'm gonna put pressure on it and you cut across it and you make the hole as small as you can. You want some pointy scissors to do this with. Now we've got those three exposed, and what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go grab the mount for this side, and I'm going to go ahead and set the mount on this just so that I can see the position, because I like looking at pretty shiny things. I'm kind of like a raccoon that way, except I got lights all over me and I can't get out of here. So I'll just sit here and look pretty until they shut the cameras off. Okay, now, because with the center mounts that we have for this, we have a humongous spring assembly that has to go through a hole in the headliner. Probably the most arduous thing you do with putting these things together is poking holes in the headliner after you make all that nice tight headliner work. Then you have to go in and poke holes. These are also position specific. You can see here that it's got a set that it needs to go to. And it looks to me like it's going to go facing this way. When it goes in, that's our position right there. Short side toward the front. But first, I get to poke a hole in the headliner. I hate doing this. What you want to try to do is make a bit of a pie cut. That should be big enough to get us what we need. Okay, now I'm gonna pull my screws out. You kind of have to do that to do this. But we have our positions, so we know where they're basically supposed to go. This, hold that up. And I'm gonna use an awl, a pick, I don't know, whatever you want to call it. And I'm going to go in here, and I'm going to find that hole. And then I'll start one of the other screws to position this. Because the awl will kind of give us our start spot. Another tip I'll give you is when you're doing this, always use a really good screwdriver that the tines are really nice on the end of it. Don't get an old nasty screwdriver, because if you slip off of this screw, you will hole that headliner. And trust me, you will cuss. I know, because I've done it before. Not the cussing part, the hole in the headliner. Fixed it though. There we go. Mount for our visor in.
It's so pretty.
Looks good. All right, I'm gonna go and put this mirror in, but we're not putting this in for final because our mirror is, it actually rests over on the trim piece that goes right along here. And right now we've just got that forward pinch weld in here. While it's not gonna work for what we need to do in the long run, but I'm just gonna show you how this mounts up temporarily. Got two screws here on either side. This is pretty easy to find compared to the visor for mounting position. These get tightened in here. And you might wonder what else goes here. Basically, you have a plastic piece that goes over this and goes here, and your final screw, which this is, if you'll remember the last time when we talked about this, this little screw right here is the one that has the washer around it, and that's the one that goes in here so that you don't mess up your plastic, because if you don't have that washer on there, you can gore the plastic. This is just a temp install, like I said before. Mirror's nice and secure, then we would put the mirror on there. I want to show you this because I know that everybody's smarter than me and a lot of other people. Basically, when you put this in, this is just a plastic coating on here. This comes off whenever you do your final install. You'll take this off of here. You've got the mount in there already, but you have this little plastic piece that actually goes in here. Now, the tab goes to the outside. There's a tang on the inside that you can see right here. That goes to the inside of this. This is your piece that keeps everything rolling the way it needs to roll in there. Your visor goes in there. I've set the visor up in here. There's actually a pin cover that's supposed to be a bushing that's supposed to go on this. I don't have the bushing on there right now because I forgot to order them. But those will go on a little later. Get this installed, and that's the end of that. Your visors are set and ready to go. When you get the pin cover in here, that'll make that nice and hold that in a good position. It looks like that's ready to go. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go in, put the A-pillars in, close this bad boy out. Okay, now we're gonna be putting the A-pillar in. And basically it just installs like this, up and in. Your A-pillar, if you put your moldings in from the back, the side moldings that go into here, you're probably gonna wanna stop it right here. That's gonna give you the best sit for this. I would recommend going in and putting the middle screw in first and just starting it so that it sits in, and then using that as your midpoint, go and hunt for your top one here. Now, if you're really going precision, and sometimes I'll do this, you can actually go in and re-drill, because the factory really didn't care all that much. And sometimes these things are in weird spots and weird screw-in positions. What you can do is actually go in and re-drill the hole, my spot. So I'm gonna go in, I'm gonna take my awl, pick, whatever. I'm gonna run in here, see if I can locate that hole. And it's way up over here. It looks almost like, I don't know. What I would probably do in this case is I would actually go in and re-drill that hole. I don't want to install this because this is not the actual pinch weld that we're going to be using for this. So I want to go in and actually wait till we get this in before we start installing these screws. But what, like I said, if the screw's in a bad position or shot in off angle or whatever, you can go in and re-drill your holes. I've done it before, and that'll actually give you a good solid mount position in the correct spot. And you can do that for all of these. Like this one may be fine. And it is. It goes in right where it needs to be. This one's a little off, and I would like to see it install a little straighter then it's trying to install, so I'll go in and re-drill this hole. So that's basically everything kind of in position. And then that's just it. You know, when you go in, you got the A-pillars that gotta go in, you gotta do the trim, but you can't do the trim until you do the glass, you can't do the glass until you do the outside perimeter color, you can't do the outside perimeter color until you do the dash. So it goes. So that's our show for this week, folks. Come back next week, we're gonna be doing some more cool stuff. I'm not gonna tell you what it is because quite frankly, I'm a little concerned that every time we do that, it just doesn't seem to work out. So watch us next time on Auto Resto Mod. Have a great week.